sectronic bomb for detonation in 90 rails.
We will wipe the opposing faction from the surface of Ganon 5.
Glory to the Daleks! Glory,
glory
to the Daleks!
To the Daleks.
Glory to the Daleks. Daleks! What is happening?
The opposing faction is returning fire. We are under attack. Pursue targets. The rogue faction shall not escape justice for their crimes against Dalek purity.
We obey.
We obey.
All timelines converge in this moment. The Eternal's prophecy concludes. All eventualities will change now.
Then we must advance. Our victory is assured.
My Emperor, the offenders are attempting to open communication channels.
Display.
Incoming attackers, justify your actions or forever be damned by the Daleks.
Your views on purity have become so distorted that you do not recognize your own kin, Time Controller. You were cast from the Dalek Creed for this reason.
We do not seek your approval, Emperor, merely to reassert Dalek dominance lost under your false leadership.
Not if I can help it.
Who is the female? Identify her.
Ident codes from her vessel identify her as the Doctor.
Doctor? Why have you shown yourself here?
Oh, I have no problem with an intergalactic Dalek war, other than the fact that it will cost trillions of innocent people across the cosmos their lives, and I cannot allow that to happen. Now, who's going to be the bigger person and call it off?
This matter does not concern you, Doctor. This day belongs to the Daleks.
Not when it endangers my universe. I'll be over in a jiffy.
I told you this was a bad idea.
Not now, Peter.
Leave now, Doctor. Your presence here is of catastrophic risk to the timeline.
Not so fast! If I eat this deadly jelly baby, it'll set off a chain reaction of explosions embedded within the ship and—
Such trickery cannot fool us, Time Lady.
Oh well, it was worth a try. Anyway, my point still stands. If you want the Daleks to survive, Time Controller, give it up.
I do not see how you can argue with this matter, Doctor. Perhaps you are the one who should back down before it is too late for you.
Doctor! What have you done to her?
This is not part of our design. Go now, human, if you wish to save your friend.
It's okay. I'm fine now.
What happened there? Are you all right?
Oh, I'm sure it's nothing. Anyway, we need to get out of here.
What, and leave the Daleks to kill trillions of people?
And risk our lives in the process? It's far too dangerous.
What? That doesn't sound like you at all.
Well, you better get used to it.
You can't. I won't let you.
I beg your pardon?
You're the Doctor. The most wonderful woman in the universe. You promised to never be cruel or cowardly and to always fight against the evil and stand up for what is right. Where have you gone, Doctor? And what could possibly be so bad that you've retreated into yourself like this?
How dare you? I am a Time Lady of Gallifrey. I have saved the universe so many times now that I have the right to decide when to pull out.
Well then, if that's how it is, I'm leaving.
What?
I'm going home right now.
But Peter, I...
No, I agreed to come with you on the condition that we do some good. If you're not willing to honor that agreement anymore, I'm out.
Okay. Okay. Setting course for Somerset, 1952.
And don't come back until you've had a serious think about this.
Peter.
Doctor?
I'm afraid not. Are you Peter Vernon?
Yes. Is there a problem?
Yes. You see, my name is Romana Deverat Rolunda, but call me Romana. I have some information concerning your friend, the Doctor.
So what's happened? Is she all right?
She? I can see a lot has happened since I last saw him. Or her.
You mean, you travelled with the Doctor?
Yes. I was assigned by the High Council to help him search for the key to time. A long time ago. Anyway, to the matter at hand.
What's this?
It's a psychic container. It was found by the Shadow Proclamation in the Medusa Cascade. Shall we have a listen?
If you are receiving this message, it means that I am in a state of great suffering that means I am no longer fit to protect the universe. I am entrusting my greatest possession, my Type 40 TARDIS, to Romana, one of my oldest and dearest friends. Do not attempt to look for me, as it will only bring you pain and distress. And, Peter, I'm sorry.
So, is that it? The Doctor's gone.
It's not as simple as that, though. When did you last see her?
It's complicated. She had some sort of heart attack, or at least I think it was a heart attack, and she refused to go back and stop the Daleks. I got mad at her, and I know I shouldn't have. I was harsh on her, and I regret it to this day. I just wish I could... What's that?
One of the Doctor's consequences. Without her to protect this vulnerable planet, it could fall into a state of chaos very quickly. Out! Now! Cloister Bell! They're draining power from the TARDIS, and fast! They're trying to get in. I'll try and hold them off.
What's that?
Sonic screwdriver.
What? You've got one too? She never let me have one.
Never mind that. Do you know how to fly, the old girl?
I've just about got the hang of the basics.
Then get us out of here.
Let's see. That one, and that one, and... is this the one?
Hmm. work, Peter. I can see why she likes you.
I try. So what now?
We don't stand a chance against the Axons on our own. We have to find the Doctor. She doesn't realise it, but by sending out this psychic container, she's given us a way to find her location. I'm going to do something I probably shouldn't.
Ah, Lady Romana, you've returned.
Thank you, Castellan. Is Cardinal Yora on board?
Yes, my lady. Would you like me to summon him?
Yes. Tell him to meet us at my lab.
Of course.
Lady Romana, eh?
Well, I've made progress in my time. Come on, we need to analyse this cube. Cardinal Yora, thank you for coming on such short notice.
No worries, my lady. What can I do for you?
We need to find the location that this psychic container was sent from. It is essential to the survival of billions.
Yes, I see. It shall take some time to calculate the results. May I ask who it is that you seek?
It's the Doctor.
The Doctor, eh? You know the High Council will disapprove.
I do not seek their approval, Cardinal. I act on what I believe is right.
Very well. It is not my place to judge, after all. We shall have the results in just a moment. I have uploaded the coordinates to the container. Simply place it onto the console of your TARDIS, and it will take you straight there.
Thank you so much for your help.
It is my pleasure. Anything for a friend of the Lady Romana.
You won't regret this, Yora.
I sincerely hope not.
This is the place.
These are definitely the right coordinates, but what would bring the Doctor here?
I think something's happened here.
Why do you think that? Doctor, is that you?
Let's check it out. What is this place?
Why did you come here?
Doctor,
I told you not to come here. What are you doing here?
We came looking for you. You see,
there's a terrible danger that's threatening the universe. Yes, I know. You're not the first to come here to find me, and you won't be the last that I have to tell that I can't do this sort of thing anymore.
Why? Why, after all this time, would you turn your back on us?
You wouldn't understand.
As one time lady to another, surely you can trust me.
Look, things have been difficult lately, Romana. I wish I could tell you, but I can't. You have to leave me here. I don't want you to get hurt.
You're our friend. That's a risk we're going to take.
Okay. I wasn't sure if I would have to do this, but here we go.
What's happening?
I'm going to show you something.
And what might that be?
Yourself. You think your legacy is full of bloodshed and destruction? Well, you're wrong. Look at those people. Sarah Jane Smith, Dorothy McShane, Molly O'Sullivan, Aaron Clark, and all those yet to come. You have brought out the best in these people, and they have never stopped believing in you. If those who have followed you through all the perils that space and time have to offer have faith in you, what right have you to have so little faith in yourself?
How did you bring them all here?
With great difficulty. They were scattered all over the universe, but they could never turn down the one who made them who they are.
Peter, I'm sorry.
Yeah, me too.
I think you and I have some unfinished business to attend to, don't we?
Indeed we do.
Well then, what are we waiting for? Where's my beautiful ship?
Back again, Doctor.
Perhaps I didn't make myself clear. I said, call off the war. This time, I really have planted explosives in the bowels of your ship. They are armed and ready, and I have been through a great ordeal recently. So don't think for one second that I won't deploy them at a moment's notice.
Such treachery is not in your nature, Doctor.
Maybe not. But in these last few months, my instincts have been drowned out. And you would be extremely lucky if they resurface now.
Exterminate her.
Exterminate.
Don't say I didn't warn you. I am the Doctor, and I'll see you in hell. That's the last of the axons. It feels good to be back.
As it does to have you back with us.
And you've come a long way since those days, Romana. I'm proud of you. All of you. Speaking of which, it was all a projection, wasn't it?
Wasn't what?
All those companions. You didn't really gather them from all over the universe, did you?
So, now that Peter's not around, do you want to talk about why you exiled yourself in the first place?
Okay. As long as you promise you won't think any less of me for it.
You have my word.
Okay. I have this, condition. Sometimes, very rarely, if a Time Lord is unwilling to regenerate, the change process will hold itself back. The downside to this is that the energy is stored up in your body, and slowly it decays your cells, instead of replenishing them.
So you're worried about not being there for the universe?
Something like that, yes.
Then that's why you need to remain strong. Keep traveling, Doctor. You more than most appreciate that you must live your life to the full, however short.
Wouldn't you come with us? There's always room for one more in the TARDIS.
Oh, you know I'd love to. But sadly I can't. I have my duties on Gallifrey. They've given me a new job. Lord President of the Time Lords.
Lord President? Oh, of course! Congratulations! There will be tough times ahead, mind you, but you will be remembered.
That's all I could hope for. I could do with a lift back to the Citadel, though, if you wouldn't mind.
Of course, my lady. And Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you too, Doctor.
and a very Merry Christmas to all of you at home.